Is it just me, or is this back half of 2019 delivering the goods movie-wise? And this one is no exception. Okay, so Marriage Story. Now this is another movie I've been really looking forward to for a while. I love the creative talent behind this one. We've got Adam Driver, we've got Scarlett Johansson, and it's a film by Noah Baumbach. I think that's how you pronounce his name. If not, I do apologize. And in this film, it follows a couple played here by Adam Driver and Scarlett Johansson who are coming to terms with getting a divorce. They're trying to go about it amicably, but of course, as most people who have been divorced know, that it's not the smoothest process, and sometimes you can start out as friends, end up as enemies, and you kind of go along with them on this journey as they try to reflect on the past while dealing with the painful present. And then, yeah, you got your drama. This movie wrecked me, but in the best way possible. I think this is one of the best movies of the year. This movie also delivers career-best performances from Scarlett Johansson and Adam Driver. The two are phenomenal together in this movie, and Noah Baumbach really directs this thing with ease, with precision, and he makes some really great directorial choices to deliver one of the best dramas you're gonna see all year, for sure. Now, I will preface this review by saying this. This is not a movie that is easy to watch. It is very heavy-hitting, it's very real, it's very raw, but I think that's why it works so well and why it leaves such a lasting impression, at least, you know, why it left such a lasting impression on me. And this isn't a movie that you necessarily need to be divorced or maybe going through one to really sympathize with or really connect with. This is a movie just, if you've ever been in love and it's ended and you've kind of had to come to terms with that love ending or that relationship ending, you can really emotionally invest yourself in the story and see little bits of you in it. And that's what I was able to do and why I think I really got emotionally invested in the story and I ended up really loving both of these characters. It's a movie that isn't obsessed with point of view. It, you know, kind of takes a nuanced look at this divorce. You know, it takes a look at both sides from, you know, his perspective, her perspective, kind of showing you what they're both going through, how they're handling things for better or worse. And some of it's really heartbreaking, some of it's really sweet, some of it, you know, is hard to watch, some of it makes you cringe, but in a good way. And this movie simply just wouldn't work if you don't have Scarlett Johansson and Adam Driver delivering such excellent performances. I mean, not only do these two make for a very believable married couple, but they bring out the best in one another. I've never seen Scarlett Johansson better. I really hate when people always tell me, oh, Scarlett Johansson, she's just a pretty face, she can't act. She's a great actress, and this year especially, she has proved that she is one of the best actresses working today. I mean, just look at Jojo Rabbit, and especially look at this movie, because I've never seen her better. I've never seen her so vulnerable. She is incredible in this movie. I mean, there's one scene where she's basically just kind of venting to this lawyer that she's hired for the divorce, and it's just so real, it's so powerful, and she's just selling every second of it. And I love that Noah Baumbach, for the majority of this movie, he makes these amazing directorial choices where, especially when there's conversations happening between two characters, like that scene, for example, you know, the camera very rarely cuts away from Scarlett Johansson's character to, you know, focus on Laura Dern's lawyer character, because the focus is Scarlett Johansson's character. She's the one venting. She's the one going through this. And I felt like if it kind of bounced back and forth like a scene normally would in that case, it wouldn't have had the same effect. And he makes this choice on several occasions in the movie where he really knows exactly where he needs to put the focus, exactly where he needs to put the camera to get the most emotional weight out of every scene in this film. And these directorial choices really elevated a lot of scenes, brought out the best in his actors. He always gets great performances out of his actors, and out of actors maybe you wouldn't expect to get a great dramatic performance out of. But I really cannot stress enough how good Adam Driver and Scarlett Johansson are in this movie. Adam Driver has never been better. This guy's one of the best actors working today. I mean, he's having an amazing year. I mean, he's incredible in this. Definitely check out The Report, which just hit Amazon Prime. One of his best movies, such a great, gripping movie. But here, I have never seen him so visceral, so raw, so completely magnetic. I mean, there are scenes where you completely feel for this guy, where you are heartbroken watching what this guy is going through, because more so than Scarlett Johansson's character, he's the one who wants to keep things friendly and amicable, and he wants to keep things peaceful, especially for the sake of his son and, you know, the sake of their child. But, you know, he realizes he kind of has to surrender control to the universe, and that not everything's going to work out the way that he wanted to. He's going to have to make some sacrifices, and kind of seeing him come to grips with that, it's heartbreaking stuff, and Driver sells every damn minute of it. I mean, these two are so good in this movie, and there's especially one scene that I think is probably the best acted scene I've seen all year, where the two are having this fight in an apartment, and you could just tell it's all these, like, you know, deeply pushed down thoughts that are finally coming to the surface, and they're basically just like spewing these venomous words at one another, and you can basically see like the spit hitting their faces, and they're just going at it. But you know, this is an argument that's not just an angry argument. This is an argument that is rooted in love, and all the drama in this movie, all the conflict in this movie is rooted in such warm love that even though that this relationship has ended, there is so much love still between them, and that love kind of keeps them coming back to each other, kind of keeps them kind of coming back into each other's lives, especially for the sake of their son, like I said before. And especially, you know, showed in that scene where, like, they're saying all these awful things, but you can tell behind their eyes they hate the fact that they're saying these things, even though that they might be truthful to them. It's just watching that whole argument unfold, and especially how it's resolved, is just incredible. And that scene alone should be both of their Oscar reels, because they're phenomenal in that scene, and they're just phenomenal in the movie on a whole. But probably the biggest pleasant surprise that this movie gave me is that it's not a cynical movie about love. I mean, you, on the outside, maybe going into this movie, you might think, oh, this is a movie about divorce, this is going to be super depressing, and it's going to make me not, you know, believe in love, it's going to make me feel all cynical. No, it's actually quite the opposite, which I thought was such a great, you know, bait and switch, where you get a plot like that, but then you get a movie that's ultimately kind of hopeful. And this isn't a movie where the couple ends up back together again. I'm just going to say that now. I mean, I don't really think it's a huge spoiler, because this is a movie about divorce, and they're not going to kind of compromise that story just to have a happy ending, because it's not realistic. In life, when people get divorced, they don't have a happy ending. They don't always kind of, you know, come to terms with that, and then all of a sudden they're just like, oh, maybe we should stay together. I like the fact that the movie kind of stuck to its guns and delivered the story that it was trying to tell in the most satisfying way possible, and it just crushed it. And ultimately, this is a movie that shows you that even when a relationship ends, even when that fucking heartbreak is there to kind of just make you wince, you know, just put you in misery, there's still this part of you that is still hopeful, that you still have this heart, you know, hopeless romantic side to you. And I feel like a lot of people out there can relate to that, you know, where you've been in horrible relationships, or you've, you know, gone through a ton of heartbreak, where on the other side of it, you still want love. Humans, we want love. We want connection. It's just, it's kind of, it's in our genetic code. We want that. We crave it. We yearn for it. And I feel like this movie shows you that even when a relationship ends, something great could possibly begin. And you know, things can work out for the best. You know, sometimes two people aren't meant to be together, and that's okay. And I think that's what this movie's really, you know, bringing home in a nice, subtle, nuanced way. And I really couldn't recommend this movie enough. It's fucking phenomenal. It's a great movie, and it's on Netflix, so you can turn it on anytime you want. I mean, Adam Driver's killing the streaming game this year. I mean, between this and The Report, he is crushing it. And then he's got Star Wars in a couple weeks. Good for him. Good year. Good year. This is a movie that absolutely deserves all the praise it's been getting, especially for its two central performances, which, like I said, they're phenomenal. I think this is a movie that a wide variety of people can relate to and kind of connect with in all sorts of different ways. I'm always curious to kind of hear people's story after they watch a movie like this, because it always kind of brings a certain story out that you kind of end up reflecting upon, because the movie kind of just speaks to those certain stories or parts of your life. So if this movie or any other movie about love has kind of spoken to you in that sort of way, let me know what movie it was and, you know, what it did for you. I don't know, I'm kind of curious. Let me know. So in the end, I'm going to give Marriage Story, I'm going to give this movie an A. Easily one of the best movies of the year. I think you're going to be hearing about this one quite a bit come Oscar time. And I think it's just a phenomenally acted, really well-directed drama that is ultimately a hopeful look at love, even though it's a movie about divorce. That's right. It is hopeful. And it has divorce in it. Yes. So that is my review of Marriage Story. Really hope you enjoyed it. Really hope you take it into consideration if you consider seeing this film or not. Make sure to subscribe to my channel for more movie reviews, TV reviews, more YouTube reviewer interviews. You will not regret hitting that subscribe button. And until next time, everybody, I'm Tom Chattelbash, YouTube's most reliable movie critic.